BlackMagic's DaVinci Resolve software made a name for itself as the premium Hollywood color grading tool, but has been getting constant updates and improvements to the extent that it has become a very powerful timeline video editor with a decode and encode engine that far surpasses what Adobe Premiere uses. I've covered it quite a bit on my channel over the past few months, ever since picking up my own Blackmagic Ursa Mini Pro video camera, including a cool collab with Wendell from Level 1 Techs. One of the amazing features of the paid studio version of Resolve is its ability to set up a dedicated render server that you send your projects to for final rendering and export. That way your primary machine is free to keep editing or do something else in general. This is also really great for editing teams. We cover more of why you might want to do this in the previous video, linked in the description. Also down there will be a link to an accompanying post on the Level 1 forums, as this is a very lengthy and dense video, so you might want a written guide to follow along with the video. Come chat with us there. In this video, I'll walk you through setting up a DaVinci Resolve render server on Windows and showing you how to connect to it and send render jobs to it from other machines, including Linux and Mac computers. In another video, I'll walk you through setting up the server on Linux, if that's more your speed, and if enough demand is there, I can even set it up on Mac, but we'll have to have demand for that. For this, you'll need a few things. An operating system. I'm using Windows 10. I don't know how much this maintains updates for older versions of Windows. You'll need a dedicated graphics card. If you're using NVIDIA, you'll need the proprietary drivers installed. I have 4.17-ish installed at the time of recording, but there might be newer drivers available for you. You can use AMD cards, but Resolve will not utilize both NVIDIA and AMD cards for software in the same machine, and so far it seems like you'll have the best results with NVIDIA graphics card and NVENC acceleration, at least for now. Make sure you're on the latest drivers for your graphics card, as mentioned, just generally will be helpful. How you build out your render server is ultimately up to you. My first render server build was my old AMD FX9590 rig with an Noctua NHD15 cooler, 32 gigs of RAM, and an NVIDIA GTX 970. I added a 750 Ti to it to test GPU scaling as well. With Wendell at Level 1 Tech's headquarters, we built a ridiculous render machine with the AMD Threadripper 2970X, 64 gigs of RAM, and 4 GPUs. Although, the PSU that we had could only support 2 at a time without kicking off during renders. We tried. With our testing and sample projects I put together, we saw minimal scaling in actual render times with multiple GPUs, and jumping from, say, 1080 Ti's to 2080 Ti's didn't make much of a difference either. But especially if you're working with beefy 8K RED footage or something like that, multi-GPU will definitely benefit timeline performance while editing. But you want those in your editing machine before adding more to your rendering machine, because that's where the performance benefit is on that regard. The benefit being that even if your render machine renders slower than your editing PC, your editing PC is free to keep working. I would recommend aiming for a minimum of 32 gigs of RAM in your render PC. 64 gigs is preferred, as Resolve with 4K or higher footage can chew through RAM and VRAM like crazy. But again, prioritize specs in your editing PC for timeline performance first. The specs that you need mostly depends on the videos you'll be making, the decoders and encoders you're using, and the accelerations they can utilize, the kinds of effects, transitions and scaling you're doing, etc. With the higher end NLEs, there's no hard rule of X program can't utilize more than Y resources. Different workloads have different needs. I can make Resolve 100% max out my main system, 64 gig of RAM, 11 gigs of VRAM, and all 36 threads on my i9, but that doesn't mean that a more normal 8-core CPU won't work wonders for you in the software. My new rig I just built during my Gamdius Talos P1 RGB case review features the Intel Core i7-6900K, 32 gigs of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM at 3000 MHz, and the GTX 1080 and 970, and a super fast NVMe SSD from ADATA XPG as well. This will be both a render server and a streaming rig, and it has the specs to back it up. Build whatever you want. Thankfully, installing Resolve on Windows is fairly straightforward. You just need to pay attention while running the installer. Download the DaVinci Resolve Studio installer from BlackMagic's website. Thankfully, us studio users don't have to type in all of our personal information each time we download. That's really annoying. We can just hit download only. Run the installer. When prompted, make sure you check all of the boxes for the features that you want to install. This is especially important that you choose PostgreSQL. I always say this wrong, but that is what you need and what we will need to make the remote rendering workflow work. Make sure that is checked. Also, if you plan on using 10 gigabit networking, set up and configure your specific NIC to make sure things are running properly before proceeding. Once you're done, you'll need to let PostgreSQL through Windows Firewall. If you have a third-party firewall set up, you'll have to have separate steps for that software. But for allowing access through the Windows Firewall, hit the Start button and type Firewall. Click on Windows Defender Firewall. In this window, click on Allow an app or feature through Windows Defender Firewall over on the left side. Click where it says Change Settings and approve the UAC prompt if it pops up for you. Click Allow another app. And then click Browse next to Path and choose psql.exe. This file is located in C, Program Files, PostgreSQL, 9.5, and Bin. And replace 9.5 with whatever version happens to be installed for you. Click Add and check the box for both private and public. Depending on your network setup, I just use both. You will want to go ahead and add access for DaVinci Resolve's executables here as well for both private and public, depending on your network setup if you haven't done that already. Click OK and save and close the firewall window. This needs to be done on all machines that you wish to interact with DaVinci Resolve's shared database and remote rendering. Next, you'll want to set up file sharing between your two PCs. I'm editing on Windows and typically rendering on Linux, but it's probably easier just to communicate between Linux or between Windows, firewall providing. I also store my footage on Synology NAS drives, and mounting these on Linux can be finicky. Thankfully, on Windows, they're fairly straightforward. I primarily use mapped network paths in Explorer. However, Resolve cooperates better if you map shares to drive letters, so I kind of recommend doing that even if you only use those drive letters for Resolve. When you're at this PC, open the Options ribbon and select Map Network Drive. Browse to your file share, give it a drive letter and a name, and you're good to go. If your mapped drive letters are different across machines, Resolve will let you assign a single alias to the mount so that render machine can know that drive X on your editing machine is really Y on your rendering machine. Really handy, a huge advantage that it has over Adobe, but you will need to take note of what your drive letters are during this process. If you can't connect to shares between your PCs, your firewall rules and networking probably isn't set up correctly. Disabling the firewall entirely can usually fix this, but that's not a solution for everyone, obviously. You'll have to dig into matching your work groups, private or public network rules, and etc., and make sure the two PCs can chat before Resolve can connect. It's time to actually launch DaVinci Resolve. Launch it, activate with your license key, or make sure that your USB dongle is inserted before launching. Go through setup. We're going to set up a project server that sees and manages the project files. Both the editing client and the render server need to be connected to the same project database, and the projects need to be imported or created on that database. But the database server does not actually need to be running on the render server itself. That just makes it easier if you're in a two-system setup. Some editing studios use a Mac Mini with its fast storage as the project database server. I'm not really sure why you'd want that as a separate node in your configuration, but it is possible, so keep that in mind. Let's make a shared database. Once you've installed Resolve and you actually launch it and get it initially activated and things like that, you have a Resolve Project Server shortcut. Run that. By the way, along the way, be sure to approve any firewall exception prompts that appear and UAC security prompts and things like that. In the Project Server window, click New Database at the top. Give it a name. Once created, click on it in the database list and click Enable Sharing at the top. Approve the UAC prompt for editing the config file and you're good to go. Now open Resolve itself and expand the database's side panel. Click on New Database. In the window that appears, make sure that Connect is selected instead of Create. Click the PostgreSQL radio button. Then choose the name of your server that you created previously, type that in, and hit Connect. Once your new database is made and selected, you'll have an empty project list or an auto-generated untitled project. Leave that one there. If you need to move projects from a local database or another PC's database, you can select the project in its appropriate database in the project manager, right-click and hit Export. Save the file, And then this can take a good amount of time for bigger projects, and it doesn't really indicate that anything's happening. So if the window freezes or the program becomes unresponsive, just leave it be for a bit until it's done. Once finished, navigate to your new shared database. Right-click in the empty space of your new database and hit Import. Select that file. Again, this may become unresponsive or take a lot of time, just let it do its thing. You may have to relink your footage for the first time after you open the project after moving it between databases, but you shouldn't do that right now though. But when you do, simply select your footage in the media workspace with the project open, right-click them and choose Relink Media, and then navigate to the stored folder and tell it to find it. Next, you'll want to connect to your shared database on your editing client computer on the same network. Open Resolve's Project Manager on that computer, click New Database, leave it on Connect, and then choose the PostgreSQL radio button. Type the name, the IP address, the username, and the password that you just set on the render server or project server, and hit Add. You will need the local IP address of the render machine. To get this, open a command prompt window on your render server and type ipconfig and hit Enter. This will give you your internet adapters, and typically the network device that you want starts with 192.168, but this may differ depending on your networking. But if it is something else, you probably already know what you're doing. If PostgreSQL is set up properly on both machines and your network is cooperating, then it should add the server and you should be good to go. If not, check on your PostgreSQL configuration or your Windows firewall and make sure the computer can actually access each other through the network in the first place. Now, whenever you make new projects, you should be able to create them in the shared database from the start and be good to go, so both computers can see the projects. Now, go ahead and open that untitled project, as we need to change some settings in Resolve. Click the DaVinci Resolve menu and click Preferences. I recommend watching some guides or reading the manual to fully optimize these for your machines, but I'll cover the relevant ones that you need to change right now here. Under Memory and GPU, set how much memory you want Resolve to have access to. You'll know if you need specific settings for this, otherwise all of it is probably fine. Leave GPU processing mode on auto, unless you have a reason to do otherwise, but check Use Display GPU for compute, unless you have another reason to. If you don't do this, single GPU systems will only end up doing all of the rendering in software CPU only mode. Here, you can also make sure that your GPUs are properly detected if you have multiple GPUs. You can use multiple GPUs and mix and match. You don't need SLI or anything. It will all take use of them within the NVIDIA platform. However, at least on Linux, Resolve only utilizes CUDA, and either way, because it does use OpenCL on Windows, it doesn't actually use both AMD and NVIDIA cards on the same machine, so you can only stack up multiple of the same platform. Go to Decode Options and make sure all of the boxes are checked. This is fine on Windows, but Use GPU for BlackMagic Raw Decode causes some glitching and crashing on Linux at the moment, but if you're never going to use BlackMagic's Raw codec from their cameras, this isn't an issue for you anyway, but worth checking on regardless. Make sure the other three boxes are checked. Next, go to Media Storage. Here you can add your local network share and your footage locations. This mount column is where the storage mounts are located according to the specific machine that you're on at the moment. Mapped mount lets you import a secondary mount location, which would be, for example, where your editing machine knows the files are, and then vice versa when you're setting up the shares on your editing machine. This is cool because it allows you to work across platforms. So on Linux, you'll have a share that is /mnt/your surname, for example, but then on Windows, it'll be a drive letter. Or between two Windows machines, you'll have X and Z on the different machines. So just make sure your drive letters are set up properly or your mount locations are set up properly as well. While you can render the file to a network storage location or even to your editing PC from your rendering machine, you'll get the best performance out of writing to a drive local to the rendering machine. I recommend setting up a shared renders folder on the render machine, mounting that on your editing PC, adding those to your media storage locations in Resolve, and setting your projects to render there during export for the best performance and fastest renders. I'll cover this more in the next section. Also, the very first location listed in your media storage files is where Resolve will store the cache files and the automatically generated versions of files and things like that, so you don't want that to be over the network either. This concludes the initial setup. Now I'll show you how to manage render jobs and some other important notes. Now that we have the database set up, you're able to create and edit projects. To prepare your render server for remote rendering, open that untitled project in your shared database, then go to the Workspace menu and choose Remote Rendering. This will let you monitor queued render jobs and the progress of ongoing renders and things like that, but it does not let you interact with the software itself, which is good, so you can't accidentally screw anything up. At the time of recording, the DaVinci Resolve manual still references a special remote rendering workspace accessible by right-clicking the empty space in Project Manager that acts as a smaller kind of queue manager, but this is outdated. The workspace is no longer available, and you must open a project and then use the Workspace menu to access this. And I've let BlackMagic staff know about that, and they should be updating the manual in time, but just so you know. You can also launch a headless remote render server by sending the launch command via a command prompt with -rr at the end. So navigate to the DaVinci Resolve program files folder in command prompt and then send resolve-rr. But this is 100% headless. You don't even get terminal-based feedback as to how the renders are progressing or anything like that. So I don't like this approach at all. Once you're ready to render something, it's time to head to the Deliver tab in Resolve on your editing computer in the project that you're editing. Give your render a file name. For location, you want to browse to a directory mapped and listed in Resolve on both machines. Again, I recommend telling it to render on a local drive inside of the render machine itself for the best performance. Make sure that you have write access to that folder in your folder sharing settings for both machines. Choose your format settings and hit Add to Render Queue. Before you hit Start Render, click the little signal or wireless looking icon next to the queue entry and choose the name of your render server. The project has to be open from within the PostgreSQL database for this to show up. It is also worth noting here that in a big and multi-editor, multi-server workflow, you can actually just tell it to render on any available machine, which might have some workflow benefits for you. There are a couple very important considerations with your video format, however. On Windows, Resolve can utilize its own native H.264 encoder, but this is not available on Linux. If you try to send a render job to a Linux render server with the native encoder option selected for H.264, it will error out because that encoder is unavailable on the server. The same thing applies if you send an NVIDIA encoder job to a machine without a NVIDIA GPU. Also, if you're editing on Mac, ProRes Export is unavailable on Windows or Linux. But DNxHR is a fantastic multi-platform mezzanine codec that works on all operating systems and renders quite fast in Resolve. If you're using third-party OFX plugins, you need to make sure that they are installed and activated across all machines as well. Hopefully with this guide, updates notwithstanding, you are able to set up and run your own DaVinci Resolve render server and start offloading your render tasks or allowing more efficient teamwork. If something is not working right, typically it has to do with the PostgreSQL or Windows Firewall configurations, so I would start there. Blackmagic's forums are always there for help from other users and occasionally Blackmagic staff, and also check out my posts in the Level 1 forums as well, linked below. Down there also includes links to my other videos on the software and the subject. And while you're down there, hit the like button. If you found this video helpful, subscribe for more tech education and consider contributing on Patreon, DonorBox, YouTube channel memberships, PayPal, Ko-fi, all those things I've set up, and join our Discord server. I'm Eplesvox. I'll see you in the next one.